Do you like Steam? I really like Steam. So many games and, you know, discounts. Do you ever have enough time to play it? I don't think I ever have enough time for it. Of course, no. Okay, since I have already spent money on buying games, why I still want to waste my time on paying them? That just wouldn't make any sense. Wait, here we are. Why not train an AI to play games for me? That means I can replace Chief with an AI as my Monster Hunter partner. Okay, then how I can train an AI? Chief is not going to teach me. I need to figure it out on my own. Here's the story. In this video, I will learn how to train an AI from an AI, which is ChatGPT, and explain to you how it works. Alright, let's go start it and learn how to train an AI. Should work. The first thing that comes to mind is whether I can train my AI to play Pokemon game. This would be awesome, as it would make me the trainer of Pokemon trainers. So, should I train an AI to play Pokemon game as a starting point? I would take it as a no. That's okay. Creating a game is not difficult for me. I spent $2 on a material pack, and the game engine I choose is Phaser 3, which is easy to use and runs on the browser. The game's design is simple. Guide my rabbit to eat fruit because she's hungry. Rabbit can only choose one of four directions to move. However, there are many risks around. Rabbit cannot fall off the cliff or eat a poisonous mushroom.
Wait a moment. Before we proceed, I should inform you that you will be discussing reinforcement learning. This technique enables AI to learn by interacting with its environment, refining its behavior through trial and error and feedback. When deep neural networks are utilized for training, it's referred as deep reinforcement learning. Now, let's continue watching the video.
To keep it simple, we call our AI Anna. We give Anna a controller, then we reward Anna when Anna does something good. And of course, we punish Anna when Anna does something bad. This can train its neural network to do the right thing. That's exactly how humans' brain works. I guess, no offense if your brain works differently. It encourages you to keep doing the things that made you happy and to avoid doing things that don't make you happy. Anna, just like us, has a memory to remember experience. So, at the beginning, she will not work perfectly. In fact, it will be really bad because she has no experience. She does not know what's good, what's bad, and she even has no idea what a rabbit, mushroom, or fruit is. However, I hope that she can get better eventually because that's how things should work technically. Like any software, defining inputs and outputs is necessary for our AI system, Anna. For Anna to see the screen, we provide it with screenshot as input. The output is simply which of the four arrow buttons Anna wants to press, left, right, up, or down. We are almost there. Now we take screenshot and send to Anna using Socket.io. Anna, which is built with TensorFlow.js, will make decision by choosing one of four options and send the chosen action to the game. Then the rabbit will move one step, resulting in a new environment. This process will repeat until the game is finished. Let's see how it goes. Okay, okay, go up, go up, go up, 上去啊! Yes. Okay. Go left, Anna, go up. Yes, come back. 下去,下面。Okay, see. It's not working quite well yet. you may notice that Anna is not yet making the right decisions. That's because Anna is still quite young, and the neural network is apparently not yet fully trained. So, how do we train Anna? How does the training process work? Here are some ideas. Option 1, instruct her where to go. Option 2, advise Anna that fruit is good and mushroom is bad, and remind her that she is controlling the rabbit. Option 3, let Anna know if the last decision she made was correct or not. Okay, I will give you 3 seconds to think. 3, 2, 1. Let's consider option 1, instructing her where to go. Instead of Anna, we can use constants in a simple if-else statement. Wait, is this how people pretend their AI is working? Let's move on to the next option. Option 2, advise Anna that fruits are good for the rabbit and mushroom are bad. Also, remind her that she's in control of rabbit. This approach may work with some pre-trained models. However, the difficulty lies on converting words like good, bad, and player into numbers. As far as I know, AI primarily works with numerical data. It might work, just don't know how to make it work. Let's move on to the next option. Option 3. Let Anna know the last decision she made was correct or not. This is what we refer to as reward and punishment. To simplify things, we just call it reward. Since punishment can be seen as a special type of reward, a negative one. Now let's discuss how the reward system works. We establish a simple policy as follows. Anna sees a mushroom to the left of the rabbit. Her confidence level for going left is 0.5, which we call prediction. Therefore, she decides to go left. However, the rabbit ends up eating the mushroom and fails. In this case, adjust the prediction to negative 1, which indicates negative expectation or punishment, and use it as training data to correct the behavior. Similarly, when the rabbit eats fruit, adjust the prediction to 1, which indicates positive expectation or reward, to enforce the behavior. This approach should work. Let's see. After hundreds of training episodes, Anna ran out of memories. I realized that using screenshot may be not a good idea. To reduce the input payload size to Anna, I plan to extract the state from game directly. This is called environmental information and consists of the position of everything as numbers. It's a technique that allowed for faster training by creating multiple copies of rabbits. In this way, Anna is able to control multiple rabbits in the same episode and share experience. Same to how Naruto trained himself in the manga. Okay, I think we are almost there. Let's check it out. Can we say that's working? I would say yes. However, it's not working perfectly yet, but it's definitely better than untrained model. The success rate is higher than 50%, which is a good start. I believe we can improve the reward system. Currently, we only give Anna 1 reward. Remember, punish is kind of reward. At the very end of each episode, rendering all previous steps meaningless with a reward of 0. However, I don't want this video to be too long. If you are interested in learning about the next generation of Anna, please like the video. A special thanks to ChatGPT for technical support. Should work.